Hi and have a good day everyone. Today I want to share with you about the life cycle of plastic bag. So let's enjoy it. The contents about this video are firstly about the introduction including the history of plastic bag. Second is the life cycle of plastic bag. Third about impacts of plastic bag to the environment and lastly is conclusion or mitigation on plastic bag.
The history of plastic bag began in 1852 where Francis Will invented the paper bag making machine in 1852. Not long after, he patented this invention with his brother and together, they created the Union Paper Bag Company. This is the beginning of grocery bags as we know. In 1933, we could not rely on paper bags forever. Polyethylene was invented in 1933 by Eric Frosted and Reginald Gibson. In 1953, high-density polyethylene, HDPE, was invented in 1953 by Carl Ziegler and Erhard Holtzkamp. In 1965, Sten Gustafsson, an employee at a company called Cellavist, invented the first official plastic bag 1965. In 1976, Mobil Chemical began producing their own plastic bags in 1976. In 1982, major grocery chains Safeway and Kroger replaced their paper bags with plastic. In 1985, by the end of 1985, 75% of supermarkets offered plastic bags as an option to their customers. In 1988, 40% of grocery bags in the United States were made from plastic. In 1999, plastic bag manufacturing jobs employed over 42,000 people. The industry was booming at the time, by supplying tons of plastic bags to grocery stores. In 2007, San Francisco banned single-use plastic bags in 2007. They were the first city in country to implement this law. In 2014, California became the first state to ban single-use plastic bags in 2014. Many states followed suits, and the trend for reusable shopping bags began to take hold. Since then, Hawaii and New York have also banned that plastic bags. In 2020, plastic bags saw a resurgence because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Single-use plastic bags were more sanitary than reusable versions.
The life cycle of plastic bags consists of seven things which is raw ingredients, oil to plastics, use, landfill, decay, recycling and the end of life of plastic bags. For raw ingredients, firstly is raw material extraction. The first step of making plastic bags is to extract the raw material. This material polyethylene can be derived from either cracked natural gas or refined oil. The refinery, this refined oil or cracked natural gas, is then transmitted to a refinery, separated into varying densities. For plastic film extrusion, plastic film extrusion is the process of manufacturing raw pellets. It involves superheating and pressurizing raw LDPE, HDPE, or LLDPE plastic pellets to create a consistent molten liquid. Last is compacturing process. The last step starts with pressing the two printed sheets. Oil to plastics. Most plastic bags are made from HDPE or high-density polyethylene, A. Strong, light, rigid plastics also used in food containers, milk bottles and pipes. Petroleum is heated to produce ethylene gases. This is converted to polyethylene, which looks like porridge, then forced through holes into strings, which are cut into granules. These are heated, stretched and cooled to make bags. Use. For every one of us, 216 plastic bags a year are handed out. A typical free supermarket bags is used for an average of 20 minutes before it is thrown away. Landfill. A third of us use plastic bags as a bin liners. Another third reuse them for shopping. But eventually, more than 98% end up in landfill. About 200 million liter the countryside. Decay. Plastic bags have only been around since the 30s, so no one knows how long they last. But scientists estimate they take 400 to 1,000 years to vanish. Some are designed to turn into carbon dioxide, water and compost within a month or two but only in composter. Chemicals in some bags, particularly the inks used in printing can leak and cause poisoning or turn into noxious compounds if burned. Recycling. Only 5% of us recycle bags. UK facilities are so limited that about 100 million a year are shipped back to China. There, they are shredded, melted and turned into plastic. Beads. The dyes and inks in bags do not make them harder to recycle, but they turn the plastic gray or black. Plastic bags are cheaper than paper bags, but may be worse for the environment. 4 times as much energy is used to produce them, and 85 times as much to recycle them, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency says. But paper takes up 9 times the space of a plastic bag at landfill. The end of life. In the oceans, plastic bags and other waste kill 1 million seabirds and 100,000 animals such as whales, dolphins, turtles and seals, each year. Once the animal's body has rotted, the bag is released back into the sea to kill again and again. Now we move to the impacts of plastic bags to our environment. The major impact of plastic bags on the environment is that it takes many years too for them to decompose. In addition, toxic substances are released into the soil when plastic bags perish under sunlight and, if plastic bags are burned, they release a toxic substance into the air causing ambient air pollution. Plastic bags are dumped indiscriminately into landfills worldwide that occupy tons of hectares of land and emit dangerous methane and carbon dioxide gases as well as highly toxic leachates from these landfills during their decomposition stage. If plastic bags are not properly disposed of, they can impact the environment by causing littering and stormwater drain blockages. Plastics have been identified as a problem in the marine environment since the 1970s, but the issue of plastic pollution in marine.
As a conclusion of plastic pollution solutions, there are 5 things you can do today in order to save our environment. First, reduce your use of single-use plastics. Wherever you live, the easiest and most direct way that you can get started is by reducing your own use of single-use plastics. Second, recycle properly. This should go without saying, but when you use single-use and other plastics that can be recycled, always be sure to recycle them. Third, participate in or organize a beach or river cleanup. Help remove plastics from the ocean and prevent them from getting there in the first place by participating in or organizing a cleanup of your local beach or waterway. Fourth, avoid products containing microbiads. Tiny plastic particles, called microbiads, have become a growing source of ocean plastic pollution in recent years. Lastly, support organizations addressing plastic pollution. That's all about the life cycle of plastic bags. I hope you are really enjoy it. We also need you to like, share and subscribe this video. Thank you.